does Countdown. John Locke, Sarah Milliken, Lisa Carbuck, Ramesh Ranganathan, Phil Jupitus, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
Hello and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, the word cherophobia is the fear of fun? It's basically what Susie Dent suffers from. Noah's Ark is thought to have held 170 species of animal, much like a Finder's lasagna. And 6 to 7 seconds is the average length of a yawn. I know, because my girlfriend yawns the entire time we're making love. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's Sean Locke. I'm not saying Sean Locke is old, but his first gig was on the deck of the Titanic to celebrate Carol Vorderman's 18th birthday. And joining Sean tonight is Lisa Tarbuck. Lisa was born in Liverpool, but her family soon moved to Surrey because, well, they were living in Liverpool. Up against them this evening, it's special guest captain Sarah Milliken. Sarah Milliken, or when it comes to the letters and numbers on Countdown, it's more Sarah Millicant.
That is not a nice way to start, Jimmy Carr.
Or maybe if you're better at the game.
Maybe if you were less of a dick.
Well, then, I mean, we're changing the whole show, then. And Sarah's teammate, Ramesh Ranganathan. Ramesh used to be a teacher until he realised it was his own time he was wasting. Ramesh met his wife at the school he worked at. That's probably why he had to leave. I'm joking, of course. She was a dinner lady. Lisa, you're friends with Sean. Do you think you'll work well as a team?
Oh, I think we will, actually, because we have in the past. Mm. We used to skate together. Competitively. He's quite hard to carry, though. I found that. Oh, he did me back in.
He threw me around like a rag doll,
didn't he? I know. It was the bit of it you liked, though,
yeah.
Wasn't it?
Yeah. But we had a skirt. I love that skirt.
Then we moved into bobsleigh. That was a bit claustrophobic, though. I found that, because I was at the back, I found that a bit, ooh.
Yeah, imagine what it's like for me in the front.
Comfortable.
Now, you host a Radio 2 show on a Saturday night. What music gets you in the mood?
Anything by Ottawan.
Ottawan?
You know that track? The track Disco, D-I-C-O.
D-I-C-O?
D-I-S-C-O. Do you know that track?
You literally just bought disco. This is Countdown. You're not qualified to be here.
I'm on the radio and I can't speak.
So D-I-C-O.
Yeah. That. See, so it bodes very well, doesn't it?
No. So, Sean, talk us through a Sean Locke holiday.
What a typical Sean Locke holiday.
Yeah, what do you do on holiday?
Well, I mean, there's no such thing as a typical Sean Locke holiday because no two Sean Locke holidays are the same. Mostly because I can't ever go back anywhere. But I do like a bit of camping, and last year I had a good time. I went on a flu camp. And the whole family got given the flu. And you get paid as well. And you don't, you're just lying there shivering. You have to look after your kids, shivering on another ward. This year we're booked into Crabs Camp. Just me and the wife are going, obviously. You know about flu camp, don't you? People go and get the flu and they pay you £2,000 and you get the flu for 10 days.
Do you definitely get better? Yeah. Always?
Well, no, I mean, you don't go if you're 80. Well, go if you're 80, you know, cheaper than going to Switzerland.
OK, Romesh, it says he used to be a freestyle rapper.
Correct, bruv. Used to spit bare bars, innit? Do you know what I mean?
Will that help you at all this evening?
I think it will. There's a lot of transferable skills.
Can we hear some freestyle rap?
I'll give you a little... I come rotten like shagging Doc Cotton up the bottom. I bring the butter, you know this ain't the margarine. I'm quick to clean up the scene like my name was MC Window Lean. I bring the biryani. I'm Asian and I'm proud, but I'm not a Pakistani. I'm the player from Sri Lanka. Drink whiskey by the tanker. Step it to my crew and you get played out like a wanker.
OK. Sarah, you're a guest captain tonight. What leadership qualities do you think you'll display?
Well, I think a good leader delegates. So this one's all on you. Don't be shit, Romesh, please.
Now, you're famous, you're a cat lover, aren't you?
Yes.
Now, if your cats could speak, what do you think they might say?
Oh, I don't think it would be good. I think they'd say, put me down, I can't breathe, or...
Put me down?
No, that's... I meant just, like, on the floor.
Oh,
but
right,
maybe...
I thought just really depressed cats.
Why can't they breathe? Are you hugging them too tight?
Yeah, I squeeze them too tight. But they look like they like it. Their eyes are wide and... they're doing, like, a ee sort of noise. Like, that cat's happy, isn't it? Isn't it?
Sarah, have you got a mascot this evening?
Yes, I have. I've brought some Lucky Charms.
Lucky really. Charms?
Yeah, it's just a bit unfortunate that my Lucky Charms, as it goes, are generally quite distracting to other people. So this is my first Lucky Charm.
Yeah.
So just so you can see, it's a television with football on. Right, so I'm just going to point it sort of there.
Brilliant.
Like that, if that's all right.
So that's... Slough Bidford.
Ooh.
Bidford.
I remember this game.
So your Lucky Charm is something that will definitely distract Sean?
Well, I don't know. I mean, that's not why I brought it. I just brought it because it's my Lucky Charm, a little telly with... seems to be working
genuinely,
quite well.
We won't get anything done.
We'll get loads done, won't we?
But yeah, but I find the back of TVs fascinating.
If you're watching Slough versus Bideford, the back's a lot more fascinating.
OK, Romesh, have you got a mascot today?
Yeah. Last time I came on here, I brought on, like, a little toy lion. I don't know if you remember. You know, I might have told you about how my second son is a prick. So I brought this lion because he really liked it and I thought he'd freak out. I thought it was hilarious, man. Anyway, my wife said it's out of order. So, to be fair, I've brought something that my first son really liked. This is his favourite thing in the whole world, Nintendo DS. And he really loses his shit if he hasn't got it. And what I'm thinking is, I'm here, my wife's got no idea I've taken it. She is going to be having a bloody nightmare at home. She won't ever whatever find out because she doesn't support me or watch anything I'm on. So tomorrow, I go back, she says to me, oh, my God, he's been losing his shit, he's absolutely freaking out. And then I go, oh, isn't it here? And I look like I found it. I've ruined her evening. And I look like the hero the next day.
Awesome. Good thing. Lisa, have you got a mascot?
I have indeed.
What have you got?
I have got a picture of the first woman in space. This is Valentina Tereshkova.
How can you say that but not disco?
So the first female astronaut, when did she go
into
space?
In space.
Three
days in space. Solo. She was in there on her own. And she's about 78 now. And she says if somebody requires her to do a one-way trip to Mars, she's the woman for the job. I think, all in all, the woman's a heroine.
OK. Sean, have you got a mascot?
So, I'm not a mascot, but the other day, I was up in the loft.
Ooh.
And I was clearing out some space for my kids' paintings. I found that some of the trophies had won. I can't show any of my BAFTAs for legal reasons. And also, I lost one, because, you know, if you've got a BAFTA, if you just wear it to the cinema, you're getting free. So this was the Scrap Metal Awards. This, there we go, that was the most promising newcomer. See, that was at the Pickpocket Awards.
Ooh.
Shoplifter of the Year.
I didn't win it. Here's me Booker Prize. That was a Booker Prize there. I won it for my book. It's all about a bloke who doesn't really like mornings, but by the afternoon, he's cheered up a bit. Oh, Crufts, yeah, I remember. I got one, Crufts. It's for the most independent dog. And, have a guess what this one's for.
Archery's my guess.
Archery?
Archery.
Wrong. It's for watching archery. And this one here is for... I was in a musical. I was in West Side Story for, like... Yeah. BAFTA were really weird about me showing my BAFTA.
What did you get it for?
Oh, I think I wrote Silent Witness or something.
OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's Phil Jupitus. Phil has starred in several West End musicals, but surprisingly has a wife and two kids.
The West End musicals, I got into them quite easily because I went to boarding school.
Oh.
So, yeah, I'm not fully gay, but I've done the induction course, you know.
I could have been gay. I failed the oral. Who do you think's going to win this evening? What do you think, Phil?
I think that the Tarbuck Lock axis is looking very solid. I just sense there's a little hesitation from the Geordie and the Sri Lankan there.
Are you Sri Lankan?
I think that they're going to yank it out the bag at the end.
Is that good?
Yeah.
Okay. And with Phil, of course, it's Susie Dent. Susie is our resident lexicographer. Of course, lexicographer comes from the Latin. Lexi meaning language and cographer meaning don't get stuck next to her at a dinner party. Susie, if you could be on any game show, what would you choose?
I'm a celebrity. As long as you came with me, then I could suspend you by the ankles over a tank of piranhas until you screamed Dictionary Corner is really exciting.
And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Good-looking, sporty and academic. Some people said Rachel Riley had it all. And then she went on Strictly and we saw her dance. Rachel, is it true you're learning Russian?
Да. Да. Я люблю говорить по-русски. Я занимаюсь русским каждый день.
Can you also talk backwards? What did you just say?
I said, yeah, I love speaking Russian. I busy myself with Russian every day.
OK, all right. Yeah. Go on, teach me some
I can teach. Well, some of the words are really hard. Like, the word for hello is здравствуйте, which just doesn't sound like anything. But some words accidentally sound like English words. So it could be useful for countdown, okay, if you have to make the contestants write something down. The word for write it down is напишите.
Напишите.
And if, you know, your friends tried a bit of cake or something, they've just put it in their mouth and you want to ask them how it is, you say, nukak.
Nukak?
Nukak.
So they put something in their mouth and you want to know how it tastes, you go, nukak? Yeah, I think whoever's teaching you Russian is not teaching you Russian. I think they're having a lot more fun. OK. Now, you've been doing a lot of charity work with dogs recently. How does working with dogs compare to working with us?
Well, I've been going to things like the hearing dogs display, and I was part of the display team, so they showed you if you were deaf and you couldn't hear your alarm go off, the dog wakes you up by jumping on your chest and licking your face. So it's kind of like working here, except I don't have to ring HR afterwards.
OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Wheelbarrow. OK, let's count on everyone. Time for the first game. Sarah and Romesh, you get the first pick of the letters.
Do you want to pick while I get one of my lucky charms out? Yeah?
Yeah.
That wasn't... You looked at me like I was going to get a tit out there.
No, I've got... I find this helpful. My jury mask. Is that distracting to anyone?
It's actually more lifelike and he's here.
And I've just got some bubble wrap just to play with.
Lovely.
So, go for it. Pick some lettuce, love.
Could I get a vowel, please?
Thank you, Amish. You.
And a consonant.
S.
A vowel.
E.
Consonant.
How do you see out of these tiny eyes, Jimmy?
Who said that?
So beady.
Consonant, please.
W.
Another consonant.
F.
Vowel. Please. Sorry, that's rude. Isn't
I.
It? Vowel.
A.
And consonant.
And the last one. P.
And for the first time today, one, two, three, go. Bubble wrap was really distracting, wasn't it? Made a lot more noise than I thought it was going to. Well, poor Sean, trying to concentrate with that going on.
No, I gave up. I thought I'd watch the show.
Sean, what did you get?
5.
Lisa?
5.
Sarah?
5.
Romesh?
I got 2 5s.
Go on, tell us one of your 5s.
One of my 5s is pause.
Pause. OK. Sarah, your 5?
Spine.
OK. Sean, your 5?
Swine.
Lisa, your 5?
Fines.
Fines. 5 points for both teams. Phil, Susie, could they have done any better?
Like the teams here, I was hitting the 5s out of the park. I got my penis, I got my wipes. But the Dentster nailed it. Hit him up.
Oh, that was a bit distracted as well. Only 6s. Supine.
Ah.
Infuse. Unsafe. Quite a few 6s.
It's not long, is it? 30 sets.
No.
No.
It's easy when you're putting on pause at home.
Are you competitive, Lisa?
Well, I'll tell you something honestly. I was walking the dog and they had a kids' end of term school thing, you know, sports in the park. And I saw all the parents going, ululating. And really G'ing up their kids, and I thought, if that's competitive, then no, I'm not. Does that answer your question?
You don't always have to use kids in competition. It can be adults as well.
He's trying to get in your mind.
Yeah, exactly. I'm not going
I'm
in
not
there.
I'm not trying to get in anyone. You're trying to get in her mind.
You're like a wisp of smoke under a door. I'm not even looking at you.
I don't know if that's an insult or a compliment.
Oh, what do you mean?
A little bit of both. Insult. How could you think that might be a compliment?
What, a wisp of smoke under... Like, oh, my God, you're like a wisp of smoke under...
OK. Sean and Lisa, your turn to pick the numbers.
2 from the top, please, Rachel. And 4 from wherever you choose.
I think that's your usual now, Sean.
Yes, the usual.
The usual. 4 little, 4, 10, 8 and 3. And the big 2, 25 and 100. And the target, 336.
OK, your time starts now. Come on, Ron, I think you can do this. So the target was 336. Romesh, you used to be a maths teacher. Did you get it?
Nailed it, mate.
Awesome.
No, I didn't get it.
how close did you get?
337.
I mean, that's close. Sarah, did you get it?
I got 337 as well.
337 as well. Sean, did you get it?
335.
Ooh.
Lisa? Same for me, 335.
335. Mm-hmm. OK, how did you get 335?
I did 3 times 100 equals 300.
Yep.
Add 25, add 10.
one away. 3-3-5.
Sarah, how did you do?
I did all of that and then divided 8 by 4 to get 2, so I was just the other side of it, pointlessly.
7 points to both teams. Rachel, could it be done?
Yeah, you could have said 25 plus 3 is 28, 8 plus 4 is 12, and times them together. 3, 3, 6.
I would never have done
that. Okay, time to go across now to Dictionary Corner. Phil, what have you got for us?
Well, you remember last time I was on, what did I hit you up with? The miracle of the Japanese short poetry form, yes, the haikus.
Ooh, very
and
nice.
And after my appearance, I found a British short poetry form because a lot of people were moaning, saying, why are we promoting the Japanese? And I introduced to you the Clerihues. Welcome to Bill Juniper's Clerihue Corner.
What's a Clerihue?
A Clerihue is a four-line poem that is biographical. Edmund Clerihue Bentley, he was a teacher, and he came up with it in order to explain to his pupils, to give them a shorthand way of remembering famous people from history. So here's one of his from the book. Karl Marx was completely wrapped up in his sharks. The poor creatures seriously missed him while he was attacking the capitalist system. Here we go. The moustache of Adolf Hitler could hardly be littler. Was the thought that kept recurring to Field Marshal Goering. There you go. That's a review.
I've written a Clerihue, I think.
Go.
She is a complete twat, and her job is that she tries to say something more twatty than she said yesterday. Katie Hopkins.
It's a bold try, Ramesh. I've written one about you, sir, so here we go.
Okay.
Ramesh, Ranganathan. Jokes tickle the nation. Lady fans say he's cute, while bears like him hirsute.
Phil Jupiter's everyone. The scores at the moment, Sean and Lisa have 12, Sarah and Ramesh have 12. And here is your teaser. The words are wet norks. The clue is the IT lads love them. That's wet norks. The IT lads love them. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were wet norks. The clue was the IT lads love them. It was, of course, networks. So at the moment, it's neck and neck. Both teams are on 12 points. OK, time to mix things up a little bit. They've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Lisa and Ramesh. So, Lisa, your turn to choose the letters.
I would like a vowel, please.
Thank you, Lisa. I.
I. And another one?
E.
I'll go for a consonant, please.
R.
And another one?
V.
And please may I have another one?
T.
I'll have a vowel at this point.
A.
That's it. And the rest, let's just have consonants.
S. I had him down as a snorer, actually.
R.
And T.
OK, and your time starts now. Ramesh, how many have you got?
Listen, mate, I'm going to be honest with you, Jimmy. Smashed it with a 6. I've got a dodgy 7 as well.
What are you going to go for? What are you playing?
What do you mean?
Well, you've got to go for one or the other.
But can't I just
commit.
Have a punt?
No, you've got to either go with your 7 or your 6. What are you going to go for?
It's not game for pussies.
Yeah.
Don't try and play mind games with me, mate. I'm going to go with a 6. And my...
I mean, that mind game couldn't have gone any better, Sean. Yeah. Well done. OK, Lisa, what are you going to go for?
7.
You've got a 7?
Yeah. Shit!
Ramesh, let's hear your 6,
isn't it?
My 6 is satire.
That's good.
Yeah, also one of my hobbies.
Shame it's not your job.
Have a little sleep.
I wake up all refreshed.
Lisa, what have you got? What's
I've
your seven?
I've gone for, and it might well be dodgy, Veritas.
That was mine! If that's in there, mate, I'm going to lose my shit and walk. Because he freaked me out. It's not fair.
Oh.
It's not in. No.
Boom!
6 points to Romesh. OK, Phil. Susie, could they have done any better?
Again, the sixes were raining down. Strive averts.
That's a good seven.
Is that old Tarry's? Tarry's for a seven. But Tarry's wasn't actually thinking because...
Add the T at the end.
Add the T at the end. Tarriest.
What does that mean?
Most...
The most tarry. Like a delightful driveway.
OK, at the end of that, Sean and Lisa have 12. Sarah and Romesh are in the lead with 18. Ooh, OK, Sarah and Romesh, your turn to pick the numbers.
Sarah, would you like to pick?
I would like to pick, but before I do, I've got my friend Patty here. Can I... She's quite good for sort of look for me. Can we bring Patty out?
Sure.
Thank you.
Oh.
Oh, shit.
Thanks, Mark. Thank you. Thank you very much, love. Hello,
Romesh,
lovely.
Are you scared of snakes by any chance?
No.
I don't...
Oh, she's lovely. Look, have a little straw.
No, thanks.
Can we have two big ones?
Yeah.
Four little ones, please,
two
Rachel.
Big ones,
thanks,
four
lovely.
Little ones.
Let's hope she doesn't commit an act of mutiny.
Oh, hello. Oh, you're going down? Bored. I'm just going down there. Didn't happen.
I think Sarah's in for a treat.
It's like a wisp of smoke under your doorway, though.
Hello.
Jesus Christ.
Sean, are you finding that distracting? Because it really feels like Romesh is bearing the brunt of this.
Yeah, that wasn't kind of the plan for my teammate to be distracted. Hello, flower. What have you got, love?
I've got a nine, a one, another nine, another one.
Dude, it's coming this way.
And you got two. Come on, darling, there we're going now.
It's not facing this way.
And the target, 972.
OK, and your time starts now.
Romesh, get back there. Stop being a wuss.
Hello.
Okay, so the target was 972. Did you get it, Romesh?
Huh?
The target was 972.
My target was to remain in the studio, and I've achieved that, so I'm pretty pleased. I got 911. To be honest with you, I'm amazed I got that with what's going on here.
Sarah, what did you get?
Oh, I got 900, but I'm playing with a snake. It's awesome. I'm in my element. I really am.
Oh, me too.
Sean, did you get it?
975.
975, pretty close. Lisa?
990.
All right, Sean, I think you were the closest.
1 plus 9 is 10.
Yep.
Times 75.
750.
Is 750. Then 9 times 25 is 225.
Yep, 975.
7 points to Sean. Thank you very much, Patrick and Mark.
Thank you.
Just pop it on. Just pop it on Romesh.
No, do not. Dude, no.
Rachel, could it be done? 972.
Yep. If you say 75 plus 25 plus 9 and minus 1 for 108 and times by the other 9, 972.
I wouldn't have done that anyway.
Time to go across again to Victory Corner. Phil, what have you got for us?
Hey, the cleric heroes are back. It's what the crowd have been screaming for. Forget all the maths and the spelling. This is what it's all about. So I thought that I'd work on a few more. I've done the girls here. Maths whiz Rachel Riley, while she adds up, is smiley. Many fans imagine the situation if she was teaching them multiplication.
Very good.
Dictionary Corner's Susie Dent, while highly intelligent, will be held back by Jupitus
whose spelling is dubious.
We can spread the net a little further afield. We can go Katie Price, known as Jordan, by Peter Andre was Nordon. And just like the Great Wall of China, from space you can see her vagina.
Ladies and gentlemen, Paul Jubinus. The scores at the moment, Sarah and Ramesh have 18, Sean and Lisa are in the lead with 19. And here is your teaser. The words are epic turd, the clue is just imagine it. That's epic turd, just imagine it. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were epic turd, the clue was just imagine it. It was, of course, pictured. OK, Sarah and Ramesh, your turn to choose the letters.
Do you want to do the first half and I'll do the second half? Go for it, love.
OK, could I get two vowels and two consonants up in
you
this
can
bit?
You have two vowels and two consonants.
Are you trying to be street?
I'm not trying to be, mate. I think I'm nailing it.
O-E-D-M.
Can I have one more vowel and three consonants, please?
O-R-T-G.
And do you want to pick the last one, love?
Vowel?
Sure. A.
Oh, thank God it wasn't an
OK, and your time starts now. OK, so your target was a nine-letter word. How did you do, Ramesh?
Five.
OK, Sarah?
Six, but it's wobbly.
Lisa?
Five.
Sean?
Six.
Lisa, you're five.
I'm going to say adore.
Oh. Adore. Ramesh, you're five?
Gated, as in I live in a gated community.
No, you don't.
So, but I'm saying for the purpose of this. I'm role-playing.
Ooh. I'm just a salesman and I've called in on your posh house in the gated community.
Aren't you a tall glass of vanilla goodness?
Yes, I am! I bloody am, I've been waiting for someone to say. Let's move on before Ramesh has his way. What's your six-letter word?
Grated.
Shit!
Oh, shit.
I can't believe it.
So close! Have you even got an R hovering above the O?
I looked at gated for ages, man. There's nothing there, nothing will go in there, mate. Absolutely nailed it.
Okay, Sarah, you're six.
I had goaded and then I realised there's only one D, so I'm going to go with goated. Like when you've been attacked by a goat. Oh, shit, I've been goated.
Is goated in there, Susie?
No.
Okay, 6 points to Sean.
No, you didn't.
Susie Phil over there in Dictionary Corner, could they have done any better?
There's a couple of eights there which are rattooned.
Yeah.
What is that?
That's to shoot out new leaves or new buds if you're a plant.
Okay.
Only if you're a plant.
Only if you're a plant. And there's another eight which is dragonette, which is a marine fish.
Okay, these are words I've never heard. Are we just going on trust here that
we
she's found them?
So at the end of that, Sean and Lisa are in the lead with 25 points. Okay, on to another numbers round. Okay, Sean, Lisa, you're to pick the numbers.
Oh, I don't know if people know this. I just had a baby and I'm a bit worried about it and it's backstage. Can I just bring it out and check it?
You should probably check regularly if you've just had a baby. Yeah.
Thanks.
Listen, I don't want to scare you, but I think your husband might be a cat.
I do not mind. You're on your own here, because I'm just cuddling a cat now.
Oh. Sean, is that at all distracting for you?
Unless it was clinging to my balls.
Sarah, I think if this is distracting for anyone, it's distracting for you.
Yeah. Just gonna...
Are you breastfeeding it?
Hello, hello. Oh, look at its big, silly head.
Hello. Everyone's going, hasn't that cat got lovely big eyes? It's been backstage for half an hour with a python.
We kept them quite separate.
Get Calton, come on, I'm doing some good distracting.
Yeah. Oh, I've drawn a scary dog. Oh, get it. Back. Roof.
That is scary.
Sean, hold that up. I mean, even for a quick sketch.
You're a I mean...
OK, Sean and Lisa, your pick of the numbers.
Let's have one from the top.
Ooh.
And everywhere else.
And five little ones. Thank you, Sean. And for this numbers game, lovely. The little ones are 10, 3, another 3, 5 and 8, and the big one, 50. And the target, 881.
Oh, and your time starts now. The target was 881. Ramesh, how didn't you get it?
I got a little bit closer than you might think. 508.
Sarah?
I got 830. It's terrible, but not as terrible as Ramesh, so that's a bonus.
You were mainly playing with a cat.
Yeah, okay. Mostly.
Lisa?
I'm not entirely sure. I'd need to talk it through with a doctor, I think. I don't know what I've done, but I've a feeling I'm quite near.
Talk us through. What did you do?
Well, I've gone 3 times 50 is 150.
Yeah.
And then I've times that by 3.
Well, this is crazy talk.
450? Yeah.
450. And this is where it gets weird, because that's where I stopped working it out.
Yeah, that's pretty weird.
Yeah. So yeah. Then 5 times 10. Do you know what? I'm free scut. No. Do you know what? Stop.
Yeah, that's just too freaky.
I swear, this is where I put it on pause and I figure it out. But I didn't realise ever before how much time I'm taking.
Sean, hold on a minute. You're not going to take the piss out of her?
No.
She had a bloody good go.
What do you mean? I had a good go.
But she got 450. She had a good go.
Further away.
Let me just check. Lisa, did you used to be a maths teacher?
No, I didn't.
Fun fact, did you used to be a maths teacher?
Yes, and I left.
Go on, what did you get?
881.
Go on, tell us how you did it.
50 times... 3 times 5.
3 times 5 is 50.
This is where I went.
15. What's that? 3 times 15. 3 times 5 is 15.
Yeah.
And then you do that times 50.
750.
Yeah.
Yeah. But no, you added 3 to the 15 before you do that.
Yeah,
what's the matter with
15.
You, Rachel?
795.
10 times 8 is 80.
Yep.
Add that on.
But 875. 6 away.
Yeah, that was what I was. I thought I had another 3.
Okay, Rachel, could it be done?
This one's impossible, so 1 away is the closest.
So it's impossible for you to do this?
It's impossible for any computer, anyone.
I knew that it was impossible, so I just thought, let's just find the 500.
I had no points, and it couldn't be done, so that's a waste of everyone's time. The scores at the moment, Sarah and Ramesh have 18, Sean and Lisa have 25, and here is your final teaser. The words are Bell Lube, and the clue is, this smells lovely. That's Bell Lube, this smells lovely. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the final teaser. The words were bell lube. The clue was this smells lovely. It was, of course, bluebell. OK. Time for our final letters game. Sean and Lisa, your turn to choose the letters.
Off you go, Lisa.
Please may I have a vowel?
Thank you, Lisa. E.
And please may I have another one?
A.
Lovely. May I have a consonant?
H.
Oh, Christ. Yeah. What have you done?
And another consonant, please.
D.
And a vowel?
E.
And a consonant?
Q.
Oh, crikey. And another consonant?
P.
And another consonant?
L.
And I'm going to have another consonant.
Holy
please.
Shit!
Yes, that's right. Lovely, thank you very much.
OK, and your time starts now.
Please?
How many have you got, Ramesh?
I've got a definite 5.
OK. Sarah, what have you got?
5.
Sean?
7.
Lisa?
5.
5. OK, let's hear your 5. What's your 5?
Delt.
Delt.
D-E-A-L-T.
What's your 5, Ramesh?
Death. Death, as in, I wish upon you death.
It's like smoke wafting under a door. Sarah?
I've got death as well, but I've also got hated.
Hated and death. Oh, all the fun on this show.
I'm losing, can you tell?
Sean, for the points, you're 7.
Pleated.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Very good.
Could we have it in a sentence?
Ooh. I'm glad you pleated that skirt, because it looked shit earlier.
Could they have done any better than pleated?
Just another 7. No,
that's
have.
Another 7, which I'm fascinated by this. Tell us all about heel tap.
A heel tap is a little bit of alcohol left in the glass after you, well, it's for some people, after you've had a drink. That tiny bit of alcohol left at the bottom.
I've got special wet wipes for emptying my glass. Put them in and I'm running around and I eat them.
Death, hated, and now alcoholism. We've got it all on this show.
Never fucked a bear, though, Jimmy, have I?
I
don't go into the woods and fuck bears, so I've been a lot better than you.
Bear fucker.
Yeah.
And he tugged off a koala.
Yeah. Sicko.
Oh, we've all done that.
Goes into the woods with his picnic basket.
Oh, here comes Jimmy again. What are we doing? Run, boo-boo, run!
Oh, yeah.
I'd like to see the documentary telling all the harrowing stories of a bear in silhouette.
Well, he came up to me in a zoo.
You know when you see the bear's heads sort of on the wall?
Yeah.
You should see the room behind.
Yeah. You in there with sunglasses and a big cigar.
OK, so Sarah and Ramesh have 18, Sean and Lisa have 32. Fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's Countdown Conundrum. Your time starts now.
Salt water.
Let's have a look and see. She's only gone and bloody done it. So the final scores are Sarah and Ramesh have 18 points, but tonight's winners are Sean and Lisa with 42 points. Congratulations. You'll know the proud owner of this Countdown Wheelbarrow. Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audiences, all of you watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
The only thing more nerve-wracking than going on a date is watching the whole date back again while sitting next to the person you went on the date with. While viewers offer advice on where you're going wrong. Young, Free and Single Live begins on E4 Monday at 10. Next tonight, Bill Bailey's the guest on The Last Leg.